And good afternoon, race fans, and welcome here to NNSCRA Mobil1 Cup Series All-Star Race Qualifying. 25 drivers ready to take you to the track for a 10-minute qualifying session. 22 of those 25 will be actually trying to qualify for a good starting spot in the All-Star Race. Three of them being Kyle Corbett, Tanner Sullivan, and the fan vote winner Trent Dunham. They are actually all going to, by default, start 23rd, 24th, 25th. Regardless of where they finish in the qualifying results here today. So they're just basically going to go out there for a practice session, as it looks like the first car off the track, or onto the track, I should say, will be Zach Rogers. So let's follow the 33 off. I think I saw James Qualls coming off pit row 2 just a moment ago. But Zach Rogers there, the rookie out of Kevin Harvick Incorporated. But there's a few things we got to talk about here as far as this practice session. We're going to have to see if it actually happens in the qualifying session here today, or if we won't see it until the race. But NNSCRA took due notice of the fact that in the Mobil Open, drivers had a very difficult time of being able to pick up the draft of the car in front of them and suck up to the back bumper. Now, they've been trying this whole weekend to try and see what the flaw is that could be causing that problem. They think they may have come up with a solution, but they're not certain. So this is going to be not only a qualifying session, but it's going to give a lot of information to NNSCRA on whether or not they're making progress into us having a good Mobil 1 Cup Series All-Star race. But you see the rear spoiler there on the back of the 33. They have actually lowered it by an inch to try and help cut down drag on these machines. They think that could be a big reason why these cars are not being able to move up into the draft of the car they're trying to draft with. If you'll notice in our Mobil Open, it was basically single file for a lot of the top five, top six for a majority of that race, and the Kyle Corbett machine really did not get much of a challenge for the win at all, because nobody, be it Joshua Collard, be it Trent Dunham, be it Tanner Sullivan, they were not able to draft up to the back bumper. As we're going to see here, here's Zach Rogers, Tanner Sullivan. Let's see if they're able to draft with each other here. Zach Rogers going to come down and lay down the first official lap, 45.868, and it looks like James Qualls already beats him there. But it's going to be interesting to watch these cars here and see if they're going to be able to race with each other. Here you see they're side by side between the 20 and the 33. That could be a good sign that we're actually going to see some side by side racing in the Mobil All-Star race. Here you see the 33 tucking in behind the 20. But the 20 again seems to be getting away. And this is what NNSCRA was kind of hoping wasn't going to happen. That one car was going to be able to catch up to the other, but right now it's not looking like that's going to happen. So NNSCRA kind of perplexed here. They're going to have to still try and figure out what's going on. We are going to have pit stops in the All-Star race, which could play out a factor as well. But obviously, these fans are going to be coming here this weekend hoping for more than just a single file event. As right now, we're looking at the fastest car on track, James Qualls, our winner from Spartan. The last points paying opportunity to be able to get into the All-Star race, as he has laid down a 44.814, and right behind him is the guy who would start alongside of him, Jake Cole, with a 44.993. And you'll notice third right now on the speed charts is the Mobil Open winner, Kyle Corbett. Now, he's got a fast car. He's currently third fastest on track, but he will start, regardless of where he qualifies today, he will start in the 23rd position, hence the rules of the drivers that qualify via the Oreo Open and or get the fan vote. As a matter of fact, the fan vote winner is right back here, Trent Dunham. Just jumped to fourth fastest on the speed charts right there, actually. 45.017, hasn't quite hit the 44s, the only three that have. Well, now the only four that, well, five. Five have hit it now. Isaac Canepa, Luke Walker, James Qualls, Dylan Young, and Jake Cole. And now Kyle Corbett just hit the 44s. Right now, though, it would be James Qualls and Luke Walker. And not surprised to see Luke Walker actually be fast on track here today, because he ended up picking up his win this season at Coca-Cola Speedway. And this track is so similar to that kind of a track, and I wouldn't be surprised if this may be the same car that they raced at Coca-Cola that they brought here for this All-Star race, as he's now going to go underneath the Isaac Canepa machine. Right behind them is the 22 of Daniel Day. Let's see if Walker makes any advances for the pole. Nope, still got to be James Qualls on point. At time about 6/100ths of a second slower was Luke Walker from his fastest lap time of the day. George Roque has now popped up inside the top 10. He's now 7th fastest. There he is, drafting there with the 5 of Charles Jackson. And it looks like Bob Jones has now cracked the top 10 as well. He's now 7th fastest on track. Mason Wood is currently the 6th fastest car on track. But right now, nobody has been able to make a challenge to James Qualls or Luke Walker. Jake Cole would be the next one in line. As I think, James Qualls just cut down his lap again. 44.805 is the fastest lap on track now. Almost a 44.8 flat as you see James Qualls in there making a pit stop now. Gonna try and get some more Goodyear Eagles on there and get back on track. One driver that we were talking about in the Mobil Open that I think is going to come in with a bit of a handicap now is the guy who's actually 9th fastest on track at the current moment. That is Wolfgang Mason. Now, Wolfgang, he and Ralph Mason, I think it was Season 5 All-Star race, if I remember correctly. It might have been Season 6. But those two worked together on the final lap and ended up coming away with a 1-3 finish. Now, Ralph Mason was unable to race his way into the Mobil1 Cup Series All-Star race. And so Wolfgang's going to have to go it alone here this season, as a 44.792 was just laid down by the defending Mobil1 Cup Series Rookie of the Year, Bob Jones. You're looking now at your new pole sitter, Bob Jones, in the 38. In drafting help there from Dylan Poteet and Mason Wood. A lightning fast lap. First car now to hit the 44 sevens. And Bob Jones, who's been having a rather difficult season in the Mobil1 Cup Series, he just recently actually started to now start to work his way up through the standings again. So he's trying to make his first Mobil1 Cup Series chase for the championship. He is really looking fast here today, and that time was a 44.994. So 2/10 of a second slower. Right now, he would start on the pole position for the All-Star race. And let's watch here carefully here. This battle with him, Dylan Poteet, Mason Wood. You can see there, Poteet actually did get a run through two. And he is on the back bumper of the 38. So maybe it just took a little bit of time for them to get into a group here for us to see what's going on. So it is possible that NNSCRA may have come up with a solution to be able to have better racing in the All-Star race rather than single file. We can only hope that's going to be the case. As right now, there you see Poteet by himself was able to go to the inside of the 38. And oh, we just had a new pole sitter. Well, actually, he's not the pole sitter, but he's the Mobil Open winner, Kyle Corbett. He is now fastest on track, and Dylan Poteet is now second. Cody Lamas has now jumped up to third. So right now, the front row would consist of the pole sitter being Dylan Poteet and the outside of the front row being Cody Lamas. Suffice to say, though, that is one fast 42 Verizon Camaro. Dominated the Mobil Open. Ended up qualifying his way into the Mobil All-Star race with the victory. And now, the fastest car on track. Even though he would start in 23rd place, he is the fastest car at the current moment. And I think he actually, if I'm not mistaken, I think he just beat his own lap. Either that or he just tied it. Because his best lap was a 44.751. His last lap was a 44.751. I don't know if he beat his last lap or if he tied it. But Dylan Poteet, who we saw drafting behind the 38 of Bob Jones, his car is now the current fastest on track that would start on the pole position. And how about Kyle Busch Motorsports? Well, how about Kyle Busch Motorsports? I was going to jump to Cody Lamas, but his teammate Drew Austin just took the second position. He is now the pole sitter for the All-Star race. And the Kyle Busch Motorsports cars would start first and third, one behind the other, taking the green flag. Dylan Poteet now gets shuffled to the high side of the front row. Bob Jones would start in fourth now. James Qualls would be fifth, Luke Walker sixth. But still, the fastest car on track is the Kyle Corbett machine. And it looks like Kyle Busch Motorsports going to have quite an advantage coming down to the green flag. Both their cars will start on the inside line of rows 1 and 2 as the practice session, I believe, is now over. It is indeed. And you're looking there, Drew Austin, the only two-time winner here in the Mobil1 Cup Series in Season 7. He is going to be the pole sitter for the Mobil1 Cup Series All-Star Race. Second fastest on track today, but Kyle Corbett, regardless of being the fastest on track today, he will be starting by default in the 23rd position. But obviously, he's got a very fast Camaro. As we'll take a look at the official practice results, Corbett fastest on track, but here's the way that the starting grid is going to look for the Mobil1 Cup Series All-Star Race. Drew Austin will start on the pole. Dylan Poteet will be second. Cody Lamas third. Fourth, Bob Jones. Fifth, James Qualls. Sixth will be Luke Walker. Seventh place, Jake Cole. Eighth will be Dylan Young. Ninth place will be James Silverfox. And 10th place is going to be Daniel Day. Mason Wood will be 11th. Isaac Kenneth in 12th. 13th, George Roque. 14th will be... I think 14th will be actually Zach Rogers. 14th will be Zach Rogers. 15th will... Wait a minute. Just give me a second here, folks. I got to look at this. 10th is Daniel Day. 11th, Mason Wood. 12th, Isaac Kanepa. 13th, Zach Rogers. 14th, George Roque. 15th will be Wolfgang Mason. 16th, Trent Dunham.
Drivers, to your
15th
cars.
Will be Wolfgang Mason. 16th will actually be Austin LaPlante. Sean Henley will be 17th. 18th, Charles Jackson. Sean Galligan, didn't see much out of him. He will be 19th. 20th will be Alex May. 21st will be Jessica Shelton. 22nd will be Andy Timmons. Then 23rd will be Kyle Corbett. 24th, Tanner Sullivan. And the fan vote winner, Trent Dunham, will start in 25th. Took me a while, but I got it. And you're looking here at and it's kind of interesting. You look here, quite a number of drivers not doing so well. The Rusty Wallace Racing car, Sean Galligan, Alex May, 22nd, 23rd fastest today. And how about the Michael Norman Motorsports Chevys? Jessica Shelton and Andy Timmons, 24th and 25th here today. So I don't know if maybe they were hanging back or not, but I know that there was one team that wasn't hanging back, and that is Kyle Busch Motorsports. They will start both their cars on the inside line, so Drew Austin will have a teammate helping push him into turn one when we go green in the Mobil1 Cup Series All-Star Race. So, hope you guys enjoyed this qualifying session. Good luck to all drivers that are locked in. If you are in this list, you're basically locked into the All-Star Race, and you'll be battling for All-Star Race win. So, we congratulate Kyle Corbett on being the fastest car today, but he will start in 23rd. Congratulations to Drew Austin, second fastest today, but he'll start on the pole position. We'll see you guys next time. We got Snickers Cup Series qualifying coming your way, and hopefully with what we saw with the kind of racing out there today, we have finally figured out the problem of drivers being able to pick up the draft of the driver in front of them. So hopefully we're in for a good Mobil1 Cup Series race. We'll see you here as qualifying continues here.